You know what rivers aren't supposed to do? Flow backwards. And in Cambodia, the Tonle Sap River flip-flops twice a year. With the rainy season beginning in June, the Mekong River, which the Tonle Sap usually flows into, massively swells up. It overflows, and this forces the Tonle Sap to backtrack and return to its lake upstream instead, flooding that area in a big way. Then, when the dry season comes around in October, the rain stops, the Mekong shrinks, and the lake empties back into the Tonle Sap, flowing down into the Mekong once again. But seasonal flip-flops are nothing compared to rivers that change direction forever. Like the Amazon River. The largest river on Earth by volume flows majestically across South America, from the Andes in the west to the Atlantic in the east. Geologists analyzing sediments over here found 2 billion-year-old minerals from over here. They realized that this side of the continent used to be higher up compared to the land on this side, so the ancient Amazon flowed east to west. Then, as plate tectonics pushed the Andes up, the water followed gravity and did a old switcheroo. That's nature's handiwork, but humans have pulled off reversals of our own. This is the Chicago River. Its water, even when it's green, flows this direction. But if you were looking at this spot 200 years ago, it would have flowed this way, because humans reversed an entire river away from its natural flow. In the late 1800s, Chicago had a waste problem. All the city's pee and poo, industrial pollution, and animal waste were being flushed into the Chicago River. As it flowed from the plains to Lake Michigan, which is where the city got its drinking water. Now, this is a public health disaster waiting to happen, so engineers built a 45-kilometer-long canal connecting the Chicago River to a nearby tributary that flows into the Mississippi. It took them 8 years and thousands of workers, and when engineers finally joined the two, the river started pulling on water from Lake Michigan, reversing the river's course. This is a ridiculously impressive engineering project. So anyway, next time you're feeling indecisive, remember that even rivers sometimes change their mind. You know, just go with the flow. If you're into this, follow PBS Terra for more.